Zayn and Gigi make out in Pillow Talk music video.
So sexy, but Beyonce is looking like a queen in the new Coldplay music video.
And Kylie responds to Tyga wanting to marry her.
Oh, we've got all that and more on today's DHR.
It's a very tantalizing DHR today on this TGIF. So glad I have Ryland here with me to kick it off.
I am so happy to be here, and what makes me even more happy is that we get to talk about Adele on Friday.
Oh yes, we do. So the trailer premiere for Adele's upcoming BBC America special, Adele Live in London, it is here, and it is certainly a lot more fun than the way I've spent previous Valentine's days.
What do you mean?
In the past. Forget the romantic dinners, forget the nice, sexy outfits, forget the chocolate. Don't forget the chocolate. You can eat that while you watch. But
whatever, you are not gonna be watching Adele on Valentine's Day, Aaron. That's gonna be me, because I'm sitting, I'm like crying with my dark chocolate, not milk chocolate, because I don't wanna be fat. While you're like having a romantic day with you and Matt.
Very true.
All right, Aaron. So Kylie just released a new video saying that she wants to date none other than herself this year. So you know how she does these videos on her app. Well, this one was called Pillow Talk. Her and a friend, they were talking about relationships, and she was saying, I'm definitely a relationship girl, but these days I kind of just want to date myself. And then she went on to talk about how she's been in a relationship for the past 5 years. Before Tyga, it was Jaden Smith. And then she continued to say, now I'm just like, I feel like I really need to find myself this year and have a relationship with myself. And then she finished by saying, I feel like you need to love yourself before you can love anybody else. But Aaron, the fun doesn't stop there, because
wait,
she was, what?
Is this like part of her, I'm like realizing things in 2016, like I'm realizing, like that I'm gonna be realizing?
I think everyone around her is just realizing things, and her biggest realization in 2016 so far is that she's gonna realize to love herself.
And Tyga just a little bit. And also, do you find it interesting that she called this Pillow Talk on the same day that Zayn's single Pillow Talk is released?
That is amazing.
Isn't that weird? Like, how many times have you said Pillow Talk in your whole life?
Not many, probably never.
It's a very weird coincidence, right?
Okay, it is. But then also strange on top of that is, after she said all of this stuff about wanting to be by herself, she was then spotted last night with Tyga at One Oak in Hollywood. What do you think about this?
There are no words. Are there words, really? Does anybody go to Kylie for like life wisdom?
No.
I love her. I think she's great, but I don't go to Kylie to find truth about the meaning of life and love and relationships.
Okay, I don't either, but I'm gonna give her credit. She's just like trying to find herself. She's living her dream. It's hard when you're like dating people, you're trying to like dump somebody or like move on. It's hard to like actually break free. Like we saw with Justin and Selena for so long. It's like still
and extra hard because she's in the spotlight and everybody's watching her. Some of the stuff I would have said when I was 18 was real stupid. So I'm glad YouTube just wasn't a big thing back then.
Kylie, we feel for you. Best of luck.
Speaking of Pillow Talk, you guys probably already know this, but Zayn Malik released his very first solo music video and his first solo single, and his first real moment making out with Gigi Hadid that we could all feast our eyes on last night, and feast we did. So we'll be south of neighbors. Kicking things off in a very hot and heavy way, and there is nothing boy band about what we watched in this music video. It's psychedelic, it's sexy, it's very Illuminati inspired, in my opinion. Don't you think?
I think so a little bit. Well, now that you say that, I never even thought about it like that. But then at the same time, this video wasn't everything I was hoping for. I was hoping for like a Justin Bieber or Taylor Swift video. It wasn't like mind blowing for me, but I get it. Like, it was a cool vibe.
I was actually surprised at this. I think my expectations expectations were pretty low, not because I don't think Zayn is talented or interesting, but with all the drama with Naughty Boy in the beginning, I wasn't sure if he was gonna have it all together, and this song is amazing.
I feel like it's like a love-making song. It's like
it
a bedroom
is.
Banger.
He has even said that he wants people to have a song about sex that they can listen to and relate to because everybody has sex. Well, not everybody, but some of us.
I'm still looking for love. All right, you guys, Beyonce is continuing her world domination because Coldplay, they just released their new music video for Him for the Weekend, featuring obviously Beyonce, and we've gotta say, she stole the show looking absolutely flawless. Life is a drink, your love's about to make the stars come out. Put your wings on me when I was Alright, you guys, so conveniently enough, the video dropped just in time to get us pumped for the Super Bowl 50th halftime show, seeing that the Queen will officially be back to crown her throne. And although it's like Coldplay's show, I feel like Beyonce is really gonna almost show them up. What do you think?
Here's what I think about this. I think that Beyonce is going to reveal her pregnancy for the second time at the Super Bowl. I think this is first of all, the music video is beautiful.
Yeah.
The song is awesome. But I could not help but think when I was watching Beyonce and all the flowers with the flower background, if they paid someone to go in and retouch her so that she didn't look pregnant in this video shoot.
Because the rumors have been swirling for some time now that she's been like wearing baggy clothes, and right now it's all fan speculation. Like it's all us just being like, blah, 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 blah. But we do know that her and Jay have been trying to have a child for the past year about now.
Yeah.
So everyone's thinking she might pull like another Love on Top, but then my only problem is this is like Coldplay's headlining show. I feel like she would steal the moment, and that's kind of mean, but at the same time it's like, oh, she's Beyonce, so she can do what she wants.
I think she'd be helping Coldplay out, if I'm being honest.
I guess more people would talk about the performance.
And honestly, the more we talk about her being pregnant, the more I believe she will be pregnant or could be pregnant, because I believe whatever you speak into the universe has power, and we have the ability to impregnate Beyonce.
So she's not pregnant now, she's going to get horny from listening to all of us talk about her having a baby, then she's gonna get pregnant and we made it happen.
That's a possible theory. I'm just saying, I think we should speak it because I want these two people to procreate yet again. Little Blue Ivy's my little baby, I love her. So as promised, yesterday I posted a video on my Instagram page and told you guys to comment, and we had a lot of commenters, and so some of you guys are gonna get a shout out today. Get ready, because Mead.Key gets one, Milkomi gets one, and Mary Ann Taz gets one. You guys, thanks so much for commenting. It's so cool to see you guys react and tell us what you think about what we talk about. Also, Dan1D_123, thanks so much. I love the show too. I'm glad you guys love it.
Mm-hmm. And we have a few more for you. We have, of course, Clay Bryce, and then Alicia Cupcakes, Chris Music 88, and it's your boy Rob Thomas. Thanks for watching.
Rob Thomas. Yeah. I actually liked him as, where did Rob Thomas go in the music business?
I don't know. Maybe we could ask it's your boy Thomas. All right, you guys, that's gonna wrap it up for this Friday episode of the Daily Hollywood Rundown. But before you go, you gotta talk it out with us in the comment section below. I have to know, do you think Beyonce is pregnant? And if not, do you think we got her pregnant today?
I think we might have gotten her pregnant. I want to know that too, actually,
so.
If you think that's a good theory. Also, what did you think of Zayn's pillow talk? Did it make you get, did it get all up in your feels?
Yeah.
I was laying in bed last night when I watched it, no joke, and I was like, this is very sexy.
Me too, I was like, who can I text?
I was like, Gigi Hadid, I'm kind of crushing.
I'm always crushing.
Always.
Always.
Always. All right, you guys, weigh in. You are the experts, we're the jokes here on the show. We love you, thanks so much for watching us, and we will see you on Instagram.
Yeah, Instagram at Ryland Adams.
At Hey Aaron Robinson, be there or be square.
Yeah, and we'll also see you here on Monday.
Louis Tomlinson reveals a photo of his little mini-me in the box on the left, and of course, Rihanna and Drake's new song, Work, is everything.